Day four was not that bad, actually. It was the most states, of course, because they get smaller as you go east, or at least the ones I was going through do. So, you know, by the time you get up to Maine, you've driven through like a Band-Aid that we call New Hampshire. I love New Hampshire, by the way. But it is a teeny tiny state, and it doesn't really take too long to drive through it. You can get from Massachusetts, actually, not just Massachusetts. You can get from Boston to my house in about 2 hours. But anyway, so on day four, the biggest things I got was probably the feeling of accomplishment. I had never driven as far as I had on this trip, ever. Not on my own anyway. Like I've done Vegas to Dallas. I've done Massachusetts to Florida. Actually the same path I just did, but my dad was driving that one, so not nearly the same. I've done Dayton to Maine several times when I lived in Dayton, but I had never driven. I don't think I'd even reached 1,000 miles on my own, actually. Oh, and I'd done Massachusetts to Atlanta, and I'd done Atlanta to DC, DC back. But again, I think the only other times that I did over 1,000 miles, I had someone else in the car with me to help with pets, or I didn't have pets, or both. So this was a huge thing for me, and I had no idea how scary it was going to be until I realized how scared I was going into it. There's so much that can happen to you on the road. Like, you've got sketchy people. You've got things that can go wrong with your car. You've got things that can go wrong on the road. You've got other people who may suddenly have an event that winds up causing a massive collision on the highway. Like, 2,000 miles is a lot of room for something to go wrong. Hey, George. George is like, nothing was going to go wrong. We had this one. Aww. So anyway, the feeling of accomplishment that I got, George. The feeling of accomplishment that I got from getting myself cross country on my own and this little guy and his sister was amazing to me. And the reward I got was when I pulled up to my house for the first time and I saw it. And I had never seen it before, not in person, because with the pandemic, my parents were my eyes for me with the real estate deal. So even though it's my house, I bought it, everything else, I was relying on them to be my eyes. And they did an awesome job. They didn't lead me wrong, which I didn't think they would. I love and trust my parents completely. But oh man, that feeling of accomplishment was something else. So that was my biggest takeaway on day four. And again, my point of doing these videos for you guys is that whatever's going on in your own life, take a look and see where you can apply these same things that I did. So day one, I got off on the wrong note and went full bore ego and wound up really hurting as a result. The second day I applied conscious thought. I accepted where I was, so acceptance is a huge part. And then I adapted. And adaptation, again, also huge. So I adapted what I needed to do in order to get there. I added an extra day on the road. Instead of trying to do it in three, I did it in four, even though it wasn't a whole day. 5 hours is still a lot of driving. And I also adapted what I was doing. I added my lidocaine patches. I added a brace. I couldn't really sit there taking an opiate because that would be a bad idea driving. Plus, I only take them... Geez, I don't even think I can even tell you a cadence. I take them so infrequently and only to be able to give my body a break. And when I do take them, I sit there and I focus on the lack of pain. But even opiates right now aren't touching the nerve pain. So that's going to require surgery, unfortunately. However, again, my point is here I am facing back surgery and I got my butt over 2,000 miles across the country because that's what I wanted to do for my goals. So regardless of what is going on with you, I know that you can find a way to reach the goals that you want to reach. Just because you've had an accident or you're in chronic pain or whatever may be going in your life that you're telling yourself is holding you back now, that doesn't mean that it is the truth. Reach out to me. I would love to work with you and help you figure out how you can make the most of your life and have a fulfilling, satisfying life regardless of how much your body may hurt. Thank you so much for joining me.